Colton McCoy, Hunter McGinnessy, and Ron Hill. We will honor our nation with the playing of our national anthem. And now, our national anthem.
Our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili in Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. Which way do you like it? Three-way, four-way, five-way? Get a famous Coney double-decker or a fresh salad, burritos, burrito bowls. Don't forget the kids' menu and Gold Star's premium shakes. And get it to go through the drive-thru. Get Gold Star Chili before or after the game. Heck, you don't even need a game. Gold Star Chili and Berea, 638 Chestnut Street. You'll find us under the Gold Star. Gold
Star Chili. The flavor of Cincinnati.
We're all busy living our lives each day, packing as much as we can into work and play. But your friends at CSEP have a thing or two they'd like to remind good folks like you. An emergency can happen almost any time, so stay connected and you'll be just fine. It doesn't really matter where the news comes from. Facebook or Twitter, prepareky.com. You don't have to study up or pass an exam. Just follow the lead of the Chemical Stockpile Emergency Preparedness Program.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Mass Southern High School at Arnold Foster Creek Marbley. Boys basketball action about to get underway on a Friday night. Mass Southern will play Clinton County. Clinton County 17-6 on the season out of Region 16. Eagles are 18-5. Should be a good ball game tonight as both teams have been winning and winning a lot. Eagles coming off a probably a 2 or 3 game winning streak. Now, after having a long winning streak, they went to West Jackson and lost. And now they build a new winning streak. Today was a district draw. We'll get into that a little later on. Starting lineups real quick. Clint County, number 12, Jackson Harlan. Number 14, Jamison Summers. 21, Colin Lankford. 24 is Brett Gibson. Number 40, Kyle Coate. For the Eagles, lineup is the same. Jefferson, Michael Jefferson, number 10. Sean Short, number 11. 14 is Noah Marshall, 33, Briar Rose. And since he left his jersey at home, Kellen Miller has a new number in 32. So, lineups are set. And this one went out of bounds onto the opening tip, and it goes to the Eagles.
Good crowd. And that's going to be done with Somerset. And Somerset beat Pulaski. And let me tell you, the Eagles was on fire. They hit the foul shots was good. The last two games, they've hit 17 of 21. Maybe they're on track of that as well.
Yep. Big crowd here tonight. Thank you for watching Madison County School Sports Television on Facebook. As we settle in for a good one here. Miller, new number. Nice play in the inside. Missed for Briar Rose. Had the rebound. Lost it. I'm sorry, it's Marshall. Noah Marshall, 14. Stays with the Eagles, though. Looking to get in bounds. Michael's having a little trouble. Finds it. No, they get the five-second call. A turnover on Michael as they get the five-second call. Well, man press, and it works. It's a turnover. Sean pressured him. He's going to go back underneath the basket. It wasn't touched, so inbound underneath. Set up in the box, get looking for Michael to come back in. Now we're going to set the offense. Miller's going to take it. Little weave look we see out Southern occasionally. Back door to Miller, not there. A lot of play. Corner play, though, for Miller. Good. New number, same result. Three ball for Miller.
When Caleb gets his feet set and properly shoots the ball, that ball is usually is going to go in from the deep three.
Reminds me a lot of Brandon Fritz, the athletic director of Mass Central, when he played. If he could get set, he could knock it down. That's a walk, no call. They must have got ball on that one. Turnover. Jefferson running. Kick it. Had it taken away, but picked up by Short. Short in and out. Six and a half to play opening quarter, and we are still 3-0. 3-2. Nope. Shot way off the glass. And they get a foul. Foul on 15, 14. Summers.
So far it's been a little bit, Coach D, a little physical so far.
1-4 for Southern to start the game. Michael in the post. Yeah, they're letting him bang down low. I love that. We can keep that play all night. Almost a turnover saved by Miller. Rose from deep three. No, not his shot, I don't think, but he took it. 3-0 Eagles. Slow start. Both teams. Clinton County over 2 to begin the game. Foul on the floor, or foul on the play, is going to put to the free throw line.
Yeah, Briar kind of lost his man right there, Langford.
Foul on Rose. And to the line is Langford, 21 to the line. He misses the front. Said we had the district draw today. If you haven't heard, Eagles are playing Berea. 3-1 now. 5.5 to play. Little handoff play. Going to go over to Miller. Caleb thought. Rose elbow. That's more likely a shot. Tell you though, rebound by Harlan. Jackson Harlan. He's going to run the offense. Go 1-4 low. Pull up. Good. Nope. In and out. Nothing falling tonight.
I like Somerset when they came here last couple days ago there that they couldn't get nothing fall.
Miller, 3 from the corner. No. Both teams struggling now horribly. 1-7 for the Eagles.
It's turned cold outside, and I think the shooting tonight so far is pretty cold.
Show it, pull it, foul.
Still impressed with Southern passing the ball around, looking for the extra guy for the open guy.
Foul is against Eagles.
As Ben, you was discussing earlier today on the draw that it's good to have team ball playing, gets everybody involved.
Oh, yeah. foul on Marshall. Second foul against the Eagles. Summers at the line. He misses the front end. Second one is good. 3-2 now. Clinton County still doesn't have a basket. 2 points on two free throws. Southern 1-7 to begin this game, and that's no foul. That's a good no call, probably. It didn't affect the play. They played through it. Michael drives. It's fouled, though. It's a cheap foul if you're a Clinton County fan. Foul goes against. Don't know. I think it went against Harlan.
I think it was.
Was it 12?
40.
Yeah, it was against 12.
12, okay.
Spin move, good.
Nice shot.
Rose with the basket. And a 2-2-1 press shown. To throw over it. Get the ball back to Summers. Goes one-on-one against Miller. Shot. No. Rebound. See who they get it on. It's going against
Clinton. I think it's Harlan again, I believe. Fouled Marshall over the back on the rebound.
Going against Clinton County. That's Jackson. That'll be his second. Did someone check into the ball game? I missed. Number 10 checks in. John Davis, a senior. 4 minutes to play in the first quarter, 5-2. Slow start tonight. Down low to Mike. Jefferson double team, kicks out to Miller. Miller in the lane, floater off the glass, good. 5 points now for Caleb. Lead is 5. Davis has it, gives it up. Got to get across timeline if you're Summers. They finally do. Almost taken away and saved. Drive, dish, no. On a late foul call.
Yeah, they kind of bailed him out there at the end.
They did. They bailed Davis out big time. It's Briar Rose. That'll be his second. So Rose has 2 quick ones going to the bench. Will be Briar after the free throw attempt, which is good. Boggs into the ball game replacing Mr. Rose. Got to get him back. There you go. Rule, you can't be inside the 3-point line now. The free throw's a shot. Second one is good as well. Makes it 7-4.
And like you were saying, all the 4 points the Clinton County has all been on the free throw line.
It's pretty bad, isn't it? They haven't made a free throw or a basket yet. They're 4-6 from the line. High post not there. Good job not to force it if it's not in. Short has it. Going to drive. Has it taken away. Saved it. Miller. Back to Sean. Sean. No walk. Taken away, though. Deflected out of bounds. Good job by the big man, 24, Gibson.
Yeah, Clinton County is very active what they're doing right now. And they're overshadowing their passing lanes right there, and they're going for broke.
I like the defensive intensity of Clinton County right now. They're getting their hands up and going after it. Noah down low trying to get the post. Off the bench, Boggs, no. Rebound down to Clinton County. And he lost. I don't know what he's trying to do with the ball.
He went in between the Southern defender and his own defender.
I think he thought he was Rondo there for a second. Ask him in over the back. It should be against Noah. I think it's going to be on 14. Boggs gets the foul instead, number 3.
And that makes Southern's 4th foul on them.
Team foul number 4. 2-2-1 press once again. Having trouble getting across. Now they do. Look for a trap. There it is. They let him out. Saved. And a timeout. It's going to be a 30. Timeout, save possession. 7-4, 2:11 to go in the first quarter. Not sure if I want to waste that timeout to save possession in a 7-4 ball game, but they do. We'll keep it here on the 32nd timeout.
Kind of just a little bit of filling each other out a little bit. You know, when you first start that game, your intensity level is very high.
Southern starting off 3-11 shooting, so And Clinton County's 0-4 from the line, but they hit four free throws. So, but Southern's not shooting much better at 27%. 17 fouls already in the first quarter between both teams, so it's sloppy.
In the early game we had is the Southern JV won, I think, by like about 20 points over.
Southern JV's playing good.
Playing
freshman
really,
team's
really
undefeated as far as I know. They still haven't been lost the game this season. Future's bright up here, but we're all about the present right now. It's one of the best teams Buttry's had in a while. Travel.
They got him walk, but either they call it walk or he was an offense foul, one of the two. So
he was making his own way, but he traveled while he was doing it.
And we have Hugh Davis tonight on the statistician part right there.
Yeah, Hugh's making me sound good with all the numbers. I'm definitely not charting. 3 of 11 now for the Eagles. Going to 2 minutes in the first quarter of a 7-4 ball game. Three ball. Noah, a kid, falls out of bounds, but going the other way is Clinton. Thrown out of bounds. Deflected.
That got deflected. I thought it looked at deflected off 21 Langford, but
I didn't think Southern touched it either.
I didn't either. So
yeah. Once again, Michael Jefferson a non-factor early. A nice take. Going into the contact, couldn't get it to fall. No, I mean Miller misses the bunny. The bunny layup with 90 seconds to go in the opening quarter. Still 7-4. Miller now 2-7 from the floor, and a foul.
That's the fouls you really don't need. That senseless foul chasing behind, you know, and just make sure you can get the ball, not the hand.
McCreath into the ball game from Madison Southern. Team foul number 5 now against the Eagles.
So we're a lot of four-corner record here, old North Carolina Dean Smith style.
A lot of talk online about the shot clock this week with some games, and I'm not a big fan of a shot clock in high school, but sometimes maybe. Blocked by Marshall, but saved. Taken away now by Michael. Jefferson going in for the layup. Basket. Michael on the board now for two. A lot of pressure been shown. They get it across. 42 seconds. Get it to Davis. John Davis gives it up. Three ball. Front of Buttry. No. Michael with the board.
Got about 30 seconds left.
Plenty of time. You can slow her down. 5-point ball game. You got Miller running baseline. Underneath. Okay, now they're going to set up in a box. 8 seconds, 7. Foul. Foul is on number 14, Summers. That's his second. It's two now on Summers, so you may want to rush him out with 7 seconds. They do. They're going to get a sub in for him.
And Caleb goes out right here.
Miller goes out. Four. Who came in to replace Miller? McCreath and Boggs back in, so both of them are in. 6-5. Michael. Pump, no call. Shot, no front iron, no good. And after one quarter of play, 9-4, Madison Southern. We'll be right back after this.
Wow.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili and Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. Which way do you like it? Three-way, four-way, five-way? Get a Famous Coney double-decker or a fresh salad, burritos, burrito bowls. Don't forget the kids' menu and Gold Star's premium shakes. And get it to go through the drive-thru. Get Gold Star Chili before or after the game. Heck, you don't even need a game. Gold Star Chili and Berea, 638 Chestnut Street. You'll find us under the Gold Star.
Gold Star Chili. The flavor of Cincinnati.
Back here at Madison Southern High School, 9-4 after a quarter of play. Clinton County inbounds. Clinton County 0-4 in that first quarter on made field goals, but they hit four free throws. And they're only down five. And now they're on the basket. We down five and not make a field goal in the quarter. You got to be extremely happy if you're Clinton County.
That field goal was Langford for Clinton County, so nice little shot.
Southern didn't exactly burn it up. They were 4-15 that opening quarter. But he thought about it and he walked.
Walked right there.
Yeah.
I figure when Marshall got that from the low post in there, I think he had a chance to just go dribble left and probably made up a shot or got fouled, but he kicked it back out.
Marshall told Boggs, shoot it. If I kick it to you, shoot it. 7:21 to play before halftime. Becomes a trout, and they break over top. Has it. Langford, his second basket of the quarter. And it's now a 9-8 ball game, 1-point game.
Well, I talked to Coach Buttry early today when we was at the draw, and he said he's worried about this team just slowing it down. Like, you know, they just slows it, the ball game so down so far.
They're a Tubby
That's
Smith
what he's
top
worried
team.
About. They grind it.
They don't want to run. If I was a head coach, that's what I would run. No more of this running gun stuff. Run a half-court set. 6.5. Miller. Gives it to Michael. Cut by Miller. That's a nice look by Miller.
And I think he'll get him for a walk.
That's a walk. Good look, give and go with him, but.
Right. He should stop before there.
Jump stopped.
Yeah, jump stop about 6 feet out. Shoot the ball.
You're in the lane. Jump stop. To the bench is Boggs. Short in the game now. Got a trout. They break it. Skip pass across to number 10. Davis. Skip again. I thought they were going to go one-on-one against Miller, but they didn't. Davis, though, for three ball. No. Rebound down to Miller. Caleb running with the ball. He's going to give it up to McCreath. Over to Michael. Kind of wanted Marshall to go post to post, and he didn't do it from block to block. Michael's going to come get it now up top and run the offense. Not exactly the most exciting game we've had this season. Turnover once again. Taken away by Davis, number 10. Up and under. No. Rebound to Marshall.
Got Michael for walking there. I didn't really see that, but.
Five turnovers now against Madison Southern as they empty the bench. A couple guys coming in, it would appear.
And like you were saying, this is a little bit sluggish. It's just.
Jackson Harlan back in.
There's not no flow to the game either side, really.
No. Got 5:11 to play in the first half, and we have 17 total points. 9-8 Eagles. They break it. Straight in. Blocked by Marshall. Noah blocks it. Short picks it up, and he's going to run with it. He'll take that shot. Ball shot. Yes.
Suns is really so good in transition. They get in there, get down there, and they've spot up for that three. Had a good look at it after the miss. Block, rather.
Ray Boggs with the three to give him a 12-8 lead. Now they're going to run to Trout. High post, kick. Number 10, three ball. No. Marshall gets the rebound. Going to give it up now to Miller. Kick it over to corner. Miller shoot the three. Yes. And a timeout. A timeout to Clinton County. It's a 30-second timeout.
Well, Southern found that two's possession right there in transition. Open guy shoots a three, and the both of them knocked it down.
27% now behind the three-point line for Southern.
That's more Southern style right there than Clinton County. Like you said, Clinton County wants to take it down there, walk it down there, and set it up and slow down. And but they're playing a nice 2-3 zone, though.
3 of 11 now for the Eagles behind the three-point line.
So Southern's got just a little breathing room right here with 4:21 to go.
It's a seven-point game, so better than that 9-8 game we had a second ago.
Oh, yeah. Still, you know, Southern's defense, you know, 4 foul shots and 2 field goals.
5 fouls. They haven't committed a foul yet this half, this quarter. Kicked it right into the hands of him. He saves it. Should have been a turnover. Went right back to Clinton. And Summers has it up top. Going to go against Miller one-on-one. 12's got it. Takes it inside. Had it knocked away. Taken away. Timeout. They're going to get the 30-second timeout now. Damascus Southern. So it's a 30.
That was Boggs down there. He slapped the ball
Craig
underneath
Boggs
down
with
there
the steal.
And got it down there. So nice play by the young man.
15-8 still. 3:52 to play. 6-17 now for Madison Southern.
And Southern's picked up. I mean, their defense the whole year, Coach C, has been really good, though. I mean, you gave up, like you said right here, one quarter and a half, 8 points.
And doing all this without Briar Rose, he's on the bench with 2 fouls.
Right.
So he's been on the bench a long time now. Miller has 8 points to lead the way, but Trey Boggs has 3. Michael has 2, which we've seen Jefferson not get involved in many points areas of late. He's not having to do it.
Right. Against Somerset, though, he had 9 rebounds and I think about 8 assists.
Yeah.
I mean, he can beat you other ways. You don't have to be the scorer or nothing, but he can, you know, them 9 assists is great and 8 rebounds.
You don't always have to score to be a big contributor to the team. 3:40 to play and not sure what the Clinton County bench is throwing a fit over.
Clinton County's just sitting back when they, you know, when they make their cuts going outside, they follow outside on the zone, then they back off.
Yeah, I think they're wanting to keep Southern's 3-point looks to a minimum.
Right, correct. Now, they just got to get into the paint right here. Somebody cuts down there and then get an easy basket.
Shot is up and good. Sean Short knocks down his first 3 of the ball game. Gives him 3 points.
So that might bring them out of that zone here in the next possession down, Clinton County.
10-point game as Harlan has it, is trapped. He gives up and loses it. Turnover against him. Marshall has it.
Oh, Lord, that was danger pass there by Short there.
Yeah, I'm afraid he was going to walk with me, didn't. Short, another 3 ball. No. This one comes down to Clinton. Harlan got that rebound as well. 10-point ball game. Backside rebound from Harlan. And he is blocked but fouled.
Uh-oh. And
by Michael. And we got a Clinton County
player
down.
Down there. I believe that is
can't really see the number yet.
Number 40, I think.
It could be the Kyle Coates. He's up, though. He seems to be fine. Foul is on Jefferson, I believe.
And yeah.
To the line is number 12, Jackson Harlan. Free throw is good. They're going to get Kyle out of the ball game. He's holding that shoulder still a little bit. Replaced by John Davis. Second one is good as well for Harlan. And it's an 8-point ball game now. 2 of 14 for Clinton County from the floor after going 0 of 7 to begin the game, first quarter. That's a 2-3 extended. Rebound inside by Boggs.
Oh, nice play by Boggs.
He found a little hole and slid in and got the rebound, put back.
Yeah, he elevated up, got that rebound, came right back down, put it back up.
Turnover still by Marshall. Ahead to Miller. Miller all the way in, good.
Now, one thing I noticed about this floor tonight, it seems like it's a little slick. I've been noticing the JV game and this game here. It seems it's kind of a little bit slick, though. People's got to watch out, you know.
As you said, another kid goes to the floor. We get a timeout. It's got to be a full. Full timeout. We'll take it with them. We'll be back.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili in Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. Which way do you like it? Three-way, four-way, five-way. Get a Famous Coney double-decker or a fresh salad, burritos, burrito bowls. Don't forget the kids' menu and Gold Star's premium shakes. And get it to go through the drive-thru. Get Gold Star Chili before or after the game. Heck, you don't even need a game. Gold Star Chili and Berea, 638 Chestnut Street. You'll find us under the Gold Star.
Gold Star Chili. The flavor of Cincinnati.
Come back. And we're back at Madison Southern. Minute 39 to play before half. Eagles with a 12-point advantage over Clinton County, 22-10. The press and poor shooting has killed Clinton County tonight. Another three ball for Clinton. This one's good, though. 24. Gibson knocks down a three and makes it 22-13. Rick Marbley is going to be down with Coach Butcher at the half. We'll have that at halftime. Can't be pleased with the shooting. I mean, they're 9 of 22. Not awful. Not great. Sean with another basket. Short now with five. Break the press once again. 21, nice spin move in the paint. Good. Basket by Lankford. Lankford now with seven. We go under a minute. Michael gives it up to Caleb. Miller with a jump shot. In good. Miller now with 12. Second game in a row we've seen him go off in the first half. He had 18 the other night against Somerset here in the opening half. 9-point game with 30 seconds to play. A skip pass. They're going to give it up. He thought about that long three. Thought better of it. 22 seconds. Lost it. Taken away by Michael. Jefferson with the steal. He's running with Boggs. Boggs up and good. Boggs with 5 points off the bench. 7 points off the bench, I'm sorry. 8 seconds to play. 4, 3, 2, up. No good. Rebound comes down to Miller, and the first half is over, 28-15. Eagles now shooting roughly 50% from the floor. Good half for the Eagles. We'll take a timeout, be back with Coach Buttry's thoughts at the half. You're watching Madison County School of Sports Television.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili in Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. Okay, I checked out this Chevy Tahoe from Jack Burford Chevrolet. Nice.
What?
Ooh, this is nice. Nice Tahoe.
Ooh, watch this. It has a backup camera.
Sweet.
Ooh, no hands. Nice.
What?
You want a truck? You want a Chevy?
We'll be right back.
small car, big coverage.
We're all busy living our lives each day, packing as much as we can into work and play. But your friends at CSEP have a thing or two they'd like to remind good folks like you. An emergency can happen almost any time, so stay connected and you'll be just fine. It doesn't really matter where the news comes from. Facebook or Twitter, prepareky.com. You don't have to study up or pass an exam. Just follow the lead of the Chemical Stockpile Emergency Preparedness Program.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili and Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA.
Back here, Massachusetts Southern, second half, about to get underway. Eagles will be inbounding. Eagles shot 48% in that opening half compared to 23% for Clinton. That's how they get the big 13-point lead. Nice look underneath. Basket for Rose. Rose gets the basket to begin the second half. Answer right back, though, by number 12. Erlen with the basket. Unfortunately, to get to hear what Coach Butker had to say at the half, but I think he had to be pleased.
Yeah, he was real pleased. Like I asked him, like first quarter, you know, for the end of that, they only gave up two field goals, four foul shots. That's all the scoring was. It's kind of rough and tumble. He said, "Well, that's good. We was glad to have somebody check us up and get physical with us."
Yeah,
he liked that, and they responded very well. Then in the second quarter, about the 3 minute mark out there,
basket by Rose once again.
I said, "You got some transition baskets." So she shot the three, found the open guy, went after the block and the steal. He said, "That's our game. We find the open people and shoot."
Travel. But Rose is fired up this quarter, isn't he?
He's very fired up. But he did like the effort on there. They play hard every time out there. Different style of ball they're playing right, you know, for physical. You know, sometimes that's good when you get into region action and you know.
Nice turnover for Clinton County. And, boys, they can't be turned over too many times. They want to stay in this one. It's already 32-17. 34-17. No, we're going to get a block, though. Got ahead of myself. I thought the basket was good. Foul against Clinton. It's going to go against Choate's going to get his first foul. So, first foul of the half. And to the line is Michael Jefferson. You said earlier in the game they've been hitting the free throws as of late. And, of course, I jinx them.
I tell you, we just can't take
the
you to Vegas.
Is awful. First free throw of the night, isn't it? 0-1.
I believe so.
Yeah, it is. First free throw of the night for Southern. So, and they're at 50% now, 1-2. So Michael gets the free throw to fall, 33-17. And they check up here. Summer is going to bring up the floor against the press. Front iron. Marshall has it to Miller. The short. Sean in lane, no, but fouled. Two free throws upcoming for Sean Short. Foul, I think it's on 14. Summers. That's three now on Summers. So Summers in a little bit of foul trouble now. Doggone it. Backspin. Takes it out. Davis back in. He will replace number 40. Coates going to go out. Not the kid with three fouls. I figured for sure they'd pop out. Summers. Short. Makes the second. Got everybody in the air and hits the layup.
Nice play by Harlan right there. Yeah. Got everybody in there, and this laid a little bunny up.
Pump fake, and everybody goes up and chases. 16-point lead.
Yeah, Briar Rose, he wants the ball down low right now. He thinks it's a mismatch. He's a little bit physical, stronger than
set most of the first half. He wants to get some action.
Yeah.
He said the entire first half just about fouls. In lane, no. Gets his own miss. Out of bounds off of a Clinton County player. 5 of 12 now for Caleb Miller from the floor. Got to be illegal. 5 second.
That's the second one that Southern had that. You know, Coach Butcher probably don't like that right there.
They were trying to set a play up. Looked like they were trying to get Miller up top and just took too long to develop. Nice job, Michael, to get back and deflect it out of bounds.
Brothers couldn't kind of reel it in right there after he tipped it back there. So
back tilt, couldn't save it. One-on-one against Miller. Foul's going to go against Miller.
Even though Miller had his hands all the way up there, he got, guy jumped into him, got you know, hit him right there.
And, he was,
you know,
still moving. That's two on Miller. Yeah, he wouldn't set still. So, ninth free throw made.
And I think the game against the Briar Jumpers below 40 points when we done that game, Coach D.
It might have been. It was close.
So, you know, they've got Clinton County right now just 21 with 5:30 to go in the third quarter.
Free throws are keeping this team in it. They're 8 of 10. Oop, got a foul on the floor.
Got a foul on the floor before he took the shot there.
Lankford now picks up his first foul, team third. Eagles inbound to short up top.
Miller thought about it there, then he kind of pulled it back down.
Yeah, he faked on him. But you have to respect him because he will shoot it from there.
Oh, yeah.
So you got to get out and at least respect that shot.
There's the mismatch down there if they can get it to Breyer.
Rose working hard in the post.
There it is. Now Miller sees it. Nope.
Too late.
Go the other way.
Yeah, he's got to get out of the post. He's going to come back. High pick for Breyer. He's going to roll. Michael. Kick. Shot. Short. Yes.
Michael penetrated. Short went on the outside of the arc of three right there and dropped his in.
Short with his basket. Seventh assist, though, for Michael on that play. And out of bounds. Off the hands of Sean. Of course, he makes the basket just out of. Why not?
Get a little warm up in there.
But Michael Jefferson only has 3 points, but 7 assists.
Like I said, you know, the floor seemed like it's slick. I was talking, you know.
Three ball, no.
In there. I don't know what's going on
Saved.
With the floor.
Three ball, no. Marshall rebounds over to Miller. Short's going to give it up to Michael. Thought about dunking it. Couldn't get high enough. Timeout on the floor. Full timeout. 4:01 to play, and it's a 39-21 ball game. Full timeout. We'll take it with them. We'll be back after this.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili and Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. Which way do you like it? Three-way, four-way, five-way. Get a Famous Coney double-decker or a fresh salad, burritos, burrito bowls. Don't forget the kids' menu and Gold Star's premium shakes. And get it to go through the drive-thru. Get Gold Star Chili before or after the game. Heck, you don't even need a game. Gold Star Chili and Berea, 638 Chestnut Street. You'll find us under the Gold Star. Gold Star
Chili. The flavor of Cincinnati.
Back here to Southern after the timeout, 39-21. Clint County just trying whatever they can to try to keep it close. Another foul against Miller.
That was a nickel-dimer, I would say. You know,
he was laying on him. But
lay him a little bit, you know.
Could have been called. It couldn't have been called. But that's three now against Miller, and he will be on to the bench. Boggs in to replace him.
And Marshall's had a nice game so far. He's got 8 rebounds for Southern tonight.
Yeah. It's all about the we, not the me right now for this team. They are doing a great job playing as a team. Blocked. Marshall with another one. Head of Mike. Michael's going to run. Gives it up. Maybe a little too on selfish there, but Jefferson gets
works
the basket.
There anyway. Should have took the shot, which I agree on that play there.
I think Michael got the basket. Gives him a 20-point lead now for the Eagles. Off the glass, good. Nice play. .312 to play in the third. All Eagles so far. Block was to be called underneath from the official. He makes his way over, makes the call. Lankford. Lankford now with two fouls for Clinton County. Fouls are starting to pile up on Clinton County. Oh, if you're going to miss free throws, I guess tonight's tonight to do it. You got a good lead. But Trey McCreath back into the ballgame, number two. Front end missed once again for Rose. Boggs, McCreath, short. Not short, but Michael Jefferson, Rose, and Marshall on the floor for the Eagles. Three ball in and out. Rebound to Michael. He's going to run it in all the way up and under, and no shot. Even if it went in, it would not have counted. No shot.
I think, if it would have went in, I think I would have gave it to him.
As hard as he worked for it there, why not?
Yeah.
Foul was on who? Did you catch? I didn't catch a number either. 2:45 to play, and they didn't do a good job of communicating the foul up here. We didn't hear it, so. Boggs has it. He's going to kick corner McCreath.
Oh, Rose working like a madman.
Good flop by the Clinton County player. Good job not to give him the flop. And Rose with the basket. Can't flop like an NBAer. Nope. And they're going to get a blocking foul now against the Eagles. Is that Rose?
Yes, that's Rose.
Be his third, won't it?
If I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, three now on Breyer. Is Miller back in for Rose? So you're just trading three fouls for three fouls. Short. Jefferson to the bench. Short back in. 2:15 left. 21 goes. He draws the foul. That's all he was trying to do.
That's going to be on maybe Marshall, I believe. Let's see what they give up here.
1-5. It is. Noah Marshall, 14 with that foul. It's a 20-point ball game.
Everybody's right there in the paint. There's a little jockeying for position right there. So,
but while we got this miscommunication, let's get a sub in real quick. Eagles going to bring in a sub for Noah.
Alec Rogers comes in for the Eagles.
There you go.
And Marshall goes out.
Alec Rogers in his first action. And he probably fouled him. We got a no call there. That's a foul.
Yeah.
And a technical foul has been issued against the Clinton County player. He said one of the bad words, and a tech. So that's two fouls.
Lankford got the foul, and I think he might have got the technical or the coach did. I'm not sure.
Foul was against Lankford, and a tech was against someone. So to the line will be Sean Short. Yeah. 21 got the tech. Yeah, so. Four fouls now.
Like the other night, Somerset got the technical too. Man, I'll tell you what, Southern just frustrates you. You know, they're just like a gnat, and they won't go away, yeah.
You know, Clinton County got a tech in the JV game as well. One of their kids did, yeah. So now they get it.
It's short on the line, isn't it?
It is, number 11.
So he hits two of them in a row.
Lead is out 46-23. Now he's going to shoot tech fouls. That was the one into one he just shot. Now he's going to get his technicals.
I think that makes Sean about, I think he's 5 for 7, if I'm not mistaken, on the foul line tonight.
Sean is.
Or 5 for 6. 5 for 6.
Clinton County coach wants to talk it over for something. It's 47-23. Clinton County coach not a happy camper with the 11th region officials. Going to have a powwow.
I think what happened was it was not a one and one. I think the foul was
the technical. The technical made it 7.
Right.
Right.
So I think those two of those free throws, I think, need to come off.
May very well be.
I think that may be what they're questioning.
Heard Hugh Davis with the comment. We're going to see what they rule. But the technical foul made foul number 7. So we'll see what they say. May take a couple points off the board, but doesn't appear like it.
Not yet, anyway.
They're not taking him off yet. He's pleading the case. He's going to the scorer's table now. Buttry's at the table as well, talking to an official scorekeeper. 209, we got a lay in the game. As it stands right now, it's 47-23. Hate to tell Clinton County, but I don't think them 2 points are really going to matter at the
right.
end.
They've doubled up, Clinton right there. So. Clinton's never rebounded from that first quarter.
They did take him off. Take two free throws away from Sean.
And he makes him 3 for 4, is that correct now?
He was 5 of 6, so.
I think that's right. My math's not too good. I can't even find the on button to this.
He's 3 of 4.
Mic. So, and it's pretty bad, I tell you.
45-23 now, game back underway. 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. All Eagles. Oh, the Bulldogs of Clinton County. Nice little backdoor cut, just too deep, and they couldn't see him. Rogers in the game wanting the ball. He loses it out of bounds, though.
Yeah, bounce pass was just too
turnover.
Close to him down low.
Turnover against Rogers. That is the 8th turnover against the Eagles tonight. Minute and a half to go in the third period. 3-ball. Yes. Clinton County good.
Gibson there. Brett Gibson on the 3-ball.
45-26. That's when I'm about ready to say this and get out of hand. A couple shots and they're right back in. Oh, nice look. Nice feed. Nice layup. Short with the basket.
I just can't say enough. The Southern just play well as this group. The chemistry there, that's the main thing. Each one of them kids got each other's back there on the court, I tell you. Play great together.
Foul on the floor. It's going to go against Rogers.
And that'll be Southern. Is that
six?
Six, I believe.
I guess, yeah, fifth.
Fifth, okay.
Shot top of the key, in and out, no. Rebound down to Boggs. Michael has it. Going to run with it. Give it up. Assist. Made basket for Rogers.
It don't take long to Southern get down there in about 3 or 4 seconds through the air, Coach Don.
Michael now 7 points, 9 assists, and we're going to foul underneath against the Dogs. Foul goes against Davis, number 10. That's his second. It's 49-26.
I'm just impressed with Southern. Somerset comes up here.
It was against the Eagles. I said Davis. It wasn't. It was against Michael, his second.
But Somerset comes up here and gets stomped. Then yeah. Clinton County comes up here. In the first quarter, it was just, 2 foul shots and 2 field goals. And, for right now, it's 49-27. So we'll end up probably a 20-something point victory, more than likely.
The time you think if they get it closer, 49-28 now. Dan Reefer in the house, maybe see 36 it appears. Shooting the highlights of the Eagle domination so far through three quarters, 21 points. 20 seconds left in this third quarter. Michael has it up top, body, no foul. Boggs has it, flips it over to Miller. 10 seconds, 8 seconds.
And there goes Cavs going to make his move.
I'm about to say he's going to shoot. Nice fake, and he couldn't hit the layup, though. 2-1, the quarter is over. Shot don't count. 49-28 after three. You're watching Madison County School Sports Television. We'll be right back.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili in Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. We Which way do you like it? Three-way, four-way, five-way. Get a Famous Coney double-decker or a fresh salad, burritos, burrito bowls. Don't forget the kids menu and Gold Star's premium shakes. And get it to go through the drive-thru. Get Gold Star Chili before or after the game. Heck, you don't even need a game. Gold Star Chili and Berea, 638 Chestnut Street. You'll find us under the Gold Star.
Gold Star Chili.
The flavor of Cincinnati.
Back here in Madison Southern, fourth quarter about to get underway. Clinton Cannon will be inbounding. Eagles are shooting 48% now from the floor. It's total domination. No, I lied to you. They're shooting 57.1. 80% in that third quarter. They were 8 of 10 from the floor. Clinton Cannon shooting 30% with 11 turnovers.
And they've held Brett Gibson down. He's 2 for 10. They put the defense on him.
Right there, almost got a steal from Miller. Up and under, no good. Gets the ball in the lane, good. Basket by 12. Harlan gets the basket. Lead down to 21. Get across to Michael. He's going to give it up. Nice. I don't know who he's looking at.
He was trying to get to Noah right there. And it,
Rose gets the basket, though. I'm like you. I thought he was looking and then got lucky and got it back. 10 points now for Breyer. Shot out of the corner. No good. And we're going to get a foul here. Might be a double foul. I think they're just going to get Noah.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I think that's 40. I think going, getting a little aggressive. I'll use it as that.
This game's getting physical.
Yeah. And I think that puts his third. Is it third, too?
Second. Foul was on number 40, actually. Call Coach. He's going to put Noah to the line. That's a good WWE move there. He brought him down. 7:15 to play. It's 51-30. Two free throws coming from Noah. Back iron, no good. Miller, though, sweeps in. I think everybody must thought it was a two-shot foul. Miller gets that offensive rebound.
Miller's done that for a lot of the whole year that we've watched games. He gets a lot of rebounds off the offense in after the foul
for
shot.
A little guy, he gets in there and gets it.
I think he's averaged almost four a game.
That's a foul. They're going to get the block against Clinton. Clinton County coach is not happy. It's 21 points. He's not going to argue too much more. Fouls against Gibson. And to the line is short. We had 2 points taken away earlier on a miscommunication. Short knocking them down now. It's 14 points for Kyle or Sean tonight. Both teams in a bonus now. Clinton County in a double bonus. A lot. Southern's in the double bonus. That is a foul against Sean. It's only his first. But going to the line is number 14, Summers. Where he is 3 or 4 tonight. Maybe 4 or 5. So you're here watching the game with us. We appreciate everybody watching. My beautiful wife has joined us tonight, so I now have to quit talking about women in the crowd, Rick. My wife is here. Got to keep it clean now. 6:40 to play. Rose is fouled. And Brian Rose to the free throw line. Well, Summer's about to go home because he's got 4 fouls, and I guarantee he picks another one up before the game's over. He is a foul machine tonight. Free throw good for Rose. Lead is now 23. Looking to go 24 on the free throw make. Good. Brian Rose having a good night, considering he set the entire first half.
Right, yes.
Breyer now at 12 points. May have been a walk got away with. Up and under, no. Rebound. Marshall had the rebound. Michael, corner. Assist if it goes. Good! Sean.
He's been hot tonight. Short with the basket. He's been very good game for Sean
Michael
tonight.
With the assist. Gives him 10 assists now.
And Noah's had a good game rebounding, too. And I think, is he over 10 rebounds?
Noah does the dirty work. Basket's good.
Has he got over 10 rebounds?
Noah, is that 10 rebounds?
10 rebounds, okay.
10 assists from Mike. Noah Marshall with a basket. Good. Eagles running now. 60-33. Lead is 27. That's a foul.
It'll be over the back right there on 20.
Foul on Seth Stockton. Stockton, just a sophomore. As I said earlier, Southern drew Berea, the Pirates, first round of the district. Which on paper favors Madison Southern, so Central got modeled then, and it appears we are headed back to another Central Southern championship game.
And folks, last year, if you miss it, that was a great game last year. Southern came up a little short, I think by a point, was it a point or two?
Yeah. Go back and watch that one on YouTube. Go, you can find it under the Madison County School Sports Television's Facebook. Or on YouTube. That game was exciting last year. And it will be exciting again this season if it happens. 5.5 to go. Eagles all over this team. Three ball, though.
It was Langford right
Langford,
there.
Yep. Gives Langford 10 points now. You know, earlier today, Buttrey was a little concerned with this team. They knocked down 18 threes the other day, other night, so. Rose, jumper, good.
Nice
Rose
shot.
On fire.
He's got really a nice shot down with 6 to 10 feet out there.
Rose with 14 tonight. All in the second half, basically. He didn't have much in the first. Yeah, Rose had 2 points in the first half.
That was basket by Jackson Harlan right there. And he's going to drop the old-fashioned three-point there. But, you know, really, Clinton has not had a lot of open threes, so to speak, at.
No.
I mean, the defense at the Southern has rotated over on that. You know, it's penetration and kick back out, and that's the same thing what Southern does as well.
Southern's had a good night defensively, that's for sure. Free throw no good. Rebound comes down to the big man, 25 in the game. That's Joseph Hill in the game.
And Joseph had a good JV game. Oh, Breyer. A little
Rose
free throw.
Another one. That's 16 now for Breyer.
George Gervin, like, he may know who that is. The young kids wouldn't know who that would be, though.
Tim Horn has joined us. Good to see Tim.
Hey, Tim, what's going on?
Tim lives in Indianapolis now. Still watching his local teams, though. Tim was a Central graduate. Taken away and laid in for Clinton County. And a timeout to Clinton. It's going to be a full timeout. 4:28 to play in a 25-point game. It's a full timeout. We'll take it with them. We'll be back after this timeout.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili and Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. Relax and let Jack Burford service your vehicle. Enjoy the customer service lounge with Wi-Fi, TV, and make yourself at home with a hot cup of coffee. We've got plenty of room. Test drive a vehicle, just not in our service department.
Back here to Southern now, the Eagles, they've inbounded to Michael. Jefferson over to Miller. And back out to Mike. On the floor, you have Miller, Rose. Joseph Hill down low with the ball, fouled. So,
another thing, this thing that we're Southern's broke that press right there. They didn't panic. They couldn't get into Miller.
Hill's just a freshman.
Yeah.
He's a good-looking freshman. Had a big JV game once again.
And he, you know, had a couple dunks there. He makes a nice basket. And he's rebounded, but has a few blocks.
He's a move-in. He moved in this summer. So.
But I was saying, though, I'd like Central, don't panic. The senior leadership, what gets, you know, they couldn't find it open down here, and they finally got up to Breyer there, and they broke the press real quick.
A little quick on that free throw, though.
Yeah.
He's a working project, but they like him. They like him a lot.
A lot of potential.
Especially
right
next
there.
Year.
Yeah, the young man.
4 minutes to go. He's got to stay on the floor, though, on defense. He's a big enough kid where he doesn't have to get up and swipe. If he just stands his ground, he'll be able to block them. It's tough, though, to get a freshman to not be excited getting in a varsity game. But
got a little, you know, a little more active in there and get in there and just battle with it. You know, give your effort when you get in there and play hard.
Bogs in from Michael Jefferson Price into the last action of the night, going out with 3:57 to go.
Rebound Sean Short off the missed free throw.
Sean's had a great game. Two-point, long two-pointer, no. No, it's Clinton County team. Like, what were they coming in, 17-6?
17-6, and, you know, they beat some good.
Very good team.
Good team, good teams there they beat, so.
Rebound to Hill. Hill goes up, gets it, and gets it ahead. Boggs, Short, Sean, no.
Oh,
yes!
It went back down there. Sean Short is having the game of his life tonight.
21 now for Sean.
He's got a big smile on his face right here.
Tim's right that Hill does have a good body for a freshman. He's got a lot of room to grow into his body.
You know, he'll be working this summer about every day somewhere.
He'll be in the gym.
Oh, nice move.
Nice move and make. About number 10.
John Davis, that was a slick move right there, going down
Davis.
The paint, spinning and turning and everything.
3 minutes to play. Eagles all over. Gonna give it up. Sean wanted it. No. Miller says, I'll take it. And a nope. 68-43.
Nice shot right there.
Gibson with a basket.
Gibson hit one there. You know, at one time he's 2-for-10. Don't know what he is right now, but, you know, he's had a tough luck.
Gibson, 3-of-11 with a make.
Credit Southern's defense on that.
He's got 11. Jefferson went to the bench with 7 points, 11 assists, and 6 rebounds. It's a good night. Filled up the stat line. Hill with the offensive rebound up and in. Good.
Yeah, Hill got that rebound. When he brought it back down, though, Don, he put the ball down to below his waist. And, you know, they've already with Central's Coast Guard, they've already talked to him over UK's camp. Do not bring it down.
You can't bring that ball down if you're a big man. Nothing good can come of it. Nope. Out of bounds. Over to Clinton County. Sub in. I lied. Michael's back in. I figured Jefferson would be done for the night, but he's back in the ball game. Miller to the bench. Back in the game, number 24, Alec Rogers. Ra Rose to the bench. And it appears Clinton County has emptied their bench with 2:01 to play. On the floor, you got Michael, Trey Boggs, Sean Short, and a timeout on the floor.
So yeah, we'll he's going to take a,
I think now we're going to empty the bench.
Empty everybody out, you know.
I expect Joseph Hill to stay on the floor.
Right.
It's a full. I thought it was going to be for the subs, but apparently not. So we'll take about a 30-second timeout. Be right back.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili and Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA.
We're back here at Madison Southern, and answer Tim Horn's question there. As you can see, we hope to cover districts. We plan on it. Districts start February 20th at EKU's Alumni Coliseum. Southern drew Berea. The Model Patriots get Madison Central. Three ball out of the corner. No, that was a pass. If you ask him, it was a pass. Brought it down, and he's going to be fouled. Looks like it's going to be Hill. Actually, we've got new players in the ballgame. Let's get them in. 23, Trevor Todd, the freshman. He picks up the foul. Number 24, Alec Rogers in the game. 55, Nathan Pruitt. 25, Joseph Hill. And who's my guard up here? To Pruitt. And my other guard, number 4, Josh Reynolds, a sophomore. Minute and a half to go, 70-47, Eagles with another impressive victory tonight. I said it last game out. I know rankings don't mean nothing, but how can this team not be getting votes in the AP poll?
They got in battle for the ball right there. You know, they wouldn't let go. Referee accepted. And, you know, this stop. Play's done.
Yeah. Definitely don't need anybody getting anything stupid here.
Right.
Missing a couple of games. Hill to the bench. Number 34 checks in. Michael Moberly, a freshman, is in the ball game.
No, Southern, you know, in the next few years, I think they're set for the next couple of years.
Double zero, Hunter Buchanan, another freshman into the ball game. He's got the ball. 120 to play.
Oh, wow. Nice shot.
Todd. Trevor Todd knocks it down, gets in the book. 73 to 47. This 23, no good. Rebounded up a 20. Wide open shot. Shots up. Good.
Nice shot by the young man.
Chase Guffey. Number 3, a sophomore as well, gets the basket. Well, with Jack Burford, Chevrolet player of the ball game, and that kid is going to be nobody else but Sean Short. Sean, 21 points tonight, 6 rebounds. He did it all. He had a really good game. Might have been his best game as an Eagle.
Yes. I think it, from top to bottom, he had assists.
Definitely the best game I've seen him play.
Yeah, had some rebounds there, and this overall pretty good shooting night, too. I don't
six
know.
6-10.
6-10, 60%, you can't
four
beat
that. 4-5. I mean, he hit 4 three-pointers, 5 or 6 from the free throw line. Had 2 points taken away from him.
Yeah.
On the mix-up.
They should give them back to him, really.
So, 21 tonight for Sean Short. He is your Jack Burford Chevrolet player of the ballgame.
But I tell you, if you've not seen the Eagles team, you need to come out and see him play or, you know, listen to us and watch the game.
When will we be back? I'm not really sure. I think we'll be back maybe Monday night. The boys up here have a game. Central Girls have a game as well. Garrett County comes there. So, we'll be somewhere Monday night, it appears. Just haven't decided where yet. But more than likely, it's going to be up here.
Well, I'm going to be in mic training, I think, 090. So I'm going to be there on some mic training. So
38 seconds left.
It's going to be a long day for me.
If you got nothing going on tomorrow, I am hosting a baseball card show, Galaxy Bowling Alley. If you got baseball cards, sports memorabilia, bring them on out to Galaxy Bowling starting tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. Come see me. I may even have an autographed headshot for you from Madison County School of Sports Television. Runs 9-3. 35 seconds. Clinton County ball. 3 ball up. This team shoots a lot of threes. And they throw it away. Save. Ooh, he stepped on the baseline.
On the line
there. They gave it. But Buchanan was on the line, and they caught it.
But like I was talking before, I think Buttrey's with the next 2-3 years, he's set pretty much. Coach D, you think on his players, what we saw? We saw the JD.
I mean, they're going to be a letdown now. It's going to be tough to replace Miller and Jefferson. And Rose, there were some big shoes to fill, like George Jones sang a long time ago. Who's going to fill those shoes? They got some horses to do it, but them horses are young. They're going to be sophomores and stuff.
They're going to be growing pains right there.
They'll be growing pains perhaps next year at times. In a couple years, this team could be really good again. 5 seconds, 3 seconds, 20-point victory for the Eagles. Give this team some respect out here in the state.
Yes, them poses.
19-5 now on the season.
And remember, 4 of them losses is what, by 10 points or less?
Yes. I mean, they lost to Central by 2. They lost to, I think this Clinton County team might have beat
Lafayette
them by a couple. Lafayette by 3 or 4. West Chessman by 3. I mean, they're not getting blown out, but yet they get no love.
No love.
Madison County needs to get out and show his team some love. Good crowd tonight, though. I'll give the Unilation credit. They did come out tonight in force.
Right.
20-point win tonight, 73-53. Sean Short, your Jack Burford Chevrolet player of the ball game.
That was awesome. That was awesome. Like you said, 6-10.
I'm just impressed by Massive Southern.
Yes.
That was awesome. Domination. I mean, coming in, I thought, well, this might actually be a close game.
But, you know, like
but
I said
it wasn't.
Before, they do not get rattled, folks. When they get the press on them, they don't get rattled. When they, you know, they seem like everything flows. They know where to go. Coach Buttrey, it's probably his finest year of coaching. I mean, he's always coached
horses.
Really good. But he gets out of there when they know where to go on dribbling the ball down on the midcourt line to
quickly.
When they have the, I'm losing words right here. When they had the press on, so they find the open area. And I'm sure he's went through practice and done them, and the foul shots came a little bit better tonight at the end.
Free throws, 9 of 17. They shot 58% from the floor, but Marshall finishes with 3 points, 11 rebounds. Bravo, 16 points. 7 from Michael, but he also had 11 assists. 21 for Sean Short tonight. 12 points for Miller. 7 points for Trey Boggs off the bench. He really provided a spark off the bench. Him and McCreath are great off the bench right now. 3 points for Trevor Todd, 2 for Rogers, 2 for Hill, and that's how you get to 73. I mean, all together, just a great night. Free throws, 9 of 17. Could be better, but you win by 20. You can't complain much. So
there was a change, a momentum swing in there about 3 or 4 minutes ago in that second quarter where they got a few loose balls, as I talked to Coach Buttry at half. They came down there, spotted up, shot the three. They was there.
Yep.
That from that point on, it was on. They was in their rhythm then.
Don Foster, Rick Marlby, thank you for watching. We'll be back probably Monday night. Good night, everyone.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, Cumberland Valley National Bank, CSEP, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble Agent, Luxury Pet Services, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, May Marketing, KYMedia.net, Gold Star Chili and Berea, Real Life Community Church, Spectrum Cable, and Bison Smith CPA. Which way do you like it? Three-way, four-way, five-way. Get a Famous Coney double-decker or a fresh salad, burritos, burrito bowls. Don't forget the kids' menu and Gold Star's premium shakes. And get it to go through the drive-thru. Get Gold Star Chili before or after the game. Heck, you don't even need a game. Gold Star Chili and Berea, 638 Chestnut Street. You'll find us under the Gold Star.
Gold Star Chili.
The flavor of Cincinnati.
We're all busy living our lives each day, packing as much as we can into work and play. But your friends at CSEP have a thing or two they'd like to remind good folks like you. An emergency can happen almost any time, so stay connected and you'll be just fine. It doesn't really matter where the news comes from. Facebook or Twitter, prepareky.com. You don't have to study up or pass an exam. Just follow the lead of the Chemical Stockpile Emergency Preparedness Program.